الحمد لله الذي خصنا بأعظم كتاب أنزل، وشرفنا بأكرم رسول بعث، وفضلنا بخير شريعة شرعت، وجعلنا بفضله ومنه من خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمر بالمعروف وتنهى عن المنكر. فالحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونسترشده ونستعطيه ونعوذ به وحده سبحانه من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، ولا نظير له، ولا كفء له، ولا مثيل له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من بين خلقه وخليله، الذي بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمان ونصح للأمة وكشف الله به كل غمة. صلوات ربي وسلامه عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله، وعلى آلك وصحبك الطيبين الطائعين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم واقتفى آثارهم وعلينا معهم إلى يوم الدين، اللهم آمين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. For you who believe, fear Allah the way he deserves to be feared, and die not except in a state of Islam. May Allah bless these faces before me. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless your families and children, and grant you the reward for showing an effort and exalting an effort and showing up in his house today. May Allah gather us all in Jannat al-Na'im. Allahumma ameen. Ibad Allah, one of the ultimate signs of hikmah, one of the ultimate signs of wisdom, is for the servant to show gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Luqman, in an ayah preceded by few ayats where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala listed a list of his miraculous creation, then immediately Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ أَنِشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. And we have granted Luqman, the wise man, Luqman al-Hakim, the wisdom, to thank Allah. It is clear from this ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from his servants to show gratefulness to his ni'mah, to his favors, to his blessings over them livingly. And I mean livingly by action. Because the ayah said, أَنِشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. Thank to Allah. Allah did not say thank Allah. He said thank to Allah. You thank to Allah through your salah. You thank to Allah through being kind to your neighbors. You thank to Allah by doing good things. All referring it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed you with the ni'mah to be able to do things. Alhamdulillah, a week of celebrations. A week of celebrations for the Muslim Ummah throughout the world and in the United States. Started with the celebration of the birth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and concluded yesterday by Muslims in the United States gathered around the table of shukr, thanking Allah for the ni'mah of food, precisely the turkey which was available at the time. And in an effort to extend this celebration, I would like to describe to you today the best ni'mah that was ever revealed to mankind. What better ni'mah to humanity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us a messenger that loves us more than we love ourselves, and that he despairs and stresses over our shortcomings and rebellion. What more ni'mah is better than us recognizing that in this, because of this ni'mah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took us from the darkness of ignorance to the light of knowledge. And because of this ni'mah, the ni'mah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved us from the punishment of this dunya and from the punishment of the hereafter. And because of this ni'mah, Allah insha'Allah will grant us to drink from his hand on the day of erection. Allahumma ameen. And I constantly affirm that the best celebration of this ni'mah is to hold on tight. Hold on tight. When Allah saved us the punishment of this dunya because of him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ لِيُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَأَنْتَ فِيهِمْ وَمَا كَانَ اللَّهُ مُعَذِّبَهُمْ وَهُمْ يَسْتَغْفِرُونَ. That Allah was not to punish them while you are among them. And Allah was not to punish them while they are showing istighfar and asking forgiveness. But Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not among us right now. But his teachings are with us. And this is a great ni'mah that requires us to stop seriously and sincerely and hold on tight and thank Allah for it. And because of that, I chose to describe to you our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and to fulfill a promise that I have promised you in the past, that description that was saved to us or given to us by an old Arabian Bedouin lady who lived in the desert, that no one ever since the time of the Prophet until today was able to describe him as such, even his companions. Her name was Atika bint Khalid al-Khuza'iyya. And her nickname that everybody knew her by is Ummu Ma'bad. She was a very old lady that would sit in her tent. And she would sit in the courtyard of her tent awaiting for the travelers in the desert and offers her hospitality and gives them food and drink and dates and meat if she had. And on the day of the famous day of the migration, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companions, radiallahu anhum ajma'een, may Allah be pleased with them, Abu Bakr, and the servant of Abu Bakr, and their guide at the time, they all arrived at her tent, and they were hungry, they were starved and droughted, and they asked her for food and for drink. But sad enough, she said, I have nothing to offer you. I have nothing to offer you. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw a goat in the shade corner of the tent. And he asked Ummu Ma'bad, would you permit me please to milk this goat? She said, Bi abi anta wa ummi, by my father and my mother. She's old, she was left behind. She does not have even the strength to walk with the sheep. She has no milk. But you can. You go ahead and try. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam approaches this goat. He says his prayers. And he touches her udder. And he says, Bismillah. And all of a sudden, the udder swells and got filled with milk. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked for a pot. He fills it up and he gives it to Umm Ma'bad and asks her to drink. And then he fills it again and he gives it to his ashab and he asks him to drink. And lastly, he drinks and he says, the bearer of the cup is the last one to drink. And then he asked her for it again and he filled it. And he left it for her and he just took their camels and they went off their way. Shortly after, her husband arrives. Umm Ma'bad, what do I see? What is this? Where did you get the milk from? We only have an old sick goat. She replies, we were visited by a blessed man. Umm Ma'bad was a Bedouin. She was not a believer. She didn't even know about Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. But sincerely and spontaneously, spit out that word, we were visited by a blessed man, touched by what she has had saw, what she had seen. She was affected by the character of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and couldn't but say, we were visited by a blessed man. Abu Ma'bad, describe him to me. And here she opens up with descriptions for an old lady who has never been to school to just come up with descriptions as if she is drawing, and they say, no one can ever describe a man like a woman, and like a woman like Umm Ma'bad. And here is what she said about our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. She said, رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا ظَاهِرَ الْوَضَاءَ. I tried to do this description as close as I can to give you a taste of what she meant, even if it does not make the most common sense in English. رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا ظَاهِرَ الْوَضَاءَ. I saw a man of an obvious glare. Some would say handsome, but she said something about glowing and glare. And this is what a mu'min is about. He glows and people love him and accept him. رَأَيْتُ رَجُلًا ظَاهِرَ الْوَضَاءَ. I saw a man of an obvious glare. أَبْلَجِ الْوَجْهِ. With a lit, beautiful face. لَمْ تُعِبْهُ ثَجْلًا. He's well built. He's neither blemished by a big stomach like we do. وَلَمْ تُزْرِيهِ صَعْلًا. Nor did he have an unusually small head. وَسِيمٌ قَسِيمٌ. He's handsome and detailed. His body parts are detailed. وَفِي عَيْنَيْهِ دَعْجٌ. The pupils of his eyes are very dark. وَفِي أَشْفَارِهِ وَطَفٌ. And the edges of his eyelids and eyelashes are long. And the area around the pupils of his eyes are so white. Look at the details. She really was admiring every little piece of the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But she doesn't finish. His voice concludes, she's describing his voice to us, concludes with a charming breath. Couldn't find a meaning to that in English. وَفِي لِحْيَتِهِ كَثَافَةً وَفِي عُنُقِهِ سَطَعًا. He has a very dark hair, a rather long neck, like bodybuilders, and a thick beard, very dense, very thick, and black, pitch black. Azaj Akran, and his eyebrows are perfectly closed. They are all attached, and they are rounded. In Samata, فَعَلَيْهِ الْوَقَارِ. When he keeps silent, he's always contemplative. وَإِن تَكَلَّمَ سَمَى وَعَلَاهُ الْبَهَاءِ. And when he speaks, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, eminence and splendor shows in his words. حلو المنطق فصل لا نذر ولا هذر. He is gifted. Wallahi, even Arabs don't know what that means. We Arabs, Arabic individuals right now, even I myself, couldn't. I had to find out what these meanings are. He's a gifted speaker. Straightforward. He doesn't just go around. Whose words are neither too few, nor too much. When he speaks, you want him to say more. When you stop, he has all this pride and dignity over him. Whose words are neither too few, nor too much. كَأَنَّ مَنْطِقُهُ خَرَزَاتِ نَظْمٍ يَتَحَدَّرْنِ. He has the clearest words and the most audible voice when he speaks. His words are like sliding, stringed pearls, like those little pearls, dropping one. Each word is like a pear, but they are all within order and going through a system. أَجْمَلُ النَّاسِ وَأَبْهَاهُمْ مِنْ بَعِيدٍ. When you look at him from far, he is the most handsome of all people. وَأَجْلَاهُمْ وَأَحْسَنَهُمْ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ. And when you move closer to him, when you, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us see him, make us get closer to him, and make us gather within his group and within his people, within the muqarrabeen, from him, Allahumma ameen. And when you move closer to him, he is the most pleasant of them, most pleasant of people, most beautiful of people. Rabba, he is neither too short nor too tall. For those who are 5'9", 5'8", 5'10", don't feel that you need to be taller. The beloved was not too tall, he was not too short. لا تقتحمه عين من قصر ولا تشنأه من طول. He is of a middle height, not too tall nor too short. You will never be tired of looking at him. غصن بين غصنين. He's a branch. And the branch in Arabic refers to prosperity and greening and life. غصن بين غصنين. He's a branch between two branches, referring to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu and his servant. He's like a branch between two branches. فَهُوَ أَنْضَرُ الثَّلَاثَةِ مَنْظَرًا. For he is the most handsome of the three. وَأَحْسَنُهُمْ قَدْرًا. And he's the most important of them. لَهُ رُفَقًا يَحِفُّونَ بِهِ. He has companions who honor and surround him. He was constantly surrounded. إِنْ قَالَ أَنْصَطُوا لِقَوْلِهِ. If he spoke and said, when he speaks, they listen to his words. وَإِنْ أَمَرَ تَبَادَرُوا لِأَمْرِهِ. And when he commands, they hasten to carry out his order. مَحْشُود مَحْفُود. They serve him and rally around him. لا عابس ولا مفند. He does not frown, nor does he nag. This is the description that she said about our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wallahi, no one can ever do something like that. But Ummah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made this lady speaks through the best time of Islam, the Hijrah. So his description will remain for all Muslims throughout time to see, understand, read and follow. صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. Abu Ma'bad said, by Allah, Ya Abu Ma'bad, this is the man of Quraysh. If I see him, I will follow him. And in another narration, I will intend to follow him if I am able to. And sure enough, that happened. Ummu Ma'bad and Abu Ma'bad both went to Medina and they declared Islam and they were alive throughout time until the beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed this life. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us like those, like Ummu Ma'bad, as she saw the beautiful things in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, affected her and made her leave everything and drop her life behind and follow him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us see the teachings and strive to follow it and follow the path of our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as this is the only savory for us in this dunya and the only guarantee for us in akhirah. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَيَفَوْزَ الْمُسْتَغْفِرِينَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. So my dear brothers and sisters, the best way to show gratitude to the birth and to the ni'mah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as I mentioned, is to follow his example. And the best way to celebrate the ni'mah of our beloved sallallahu alaihi wasallam is to present him to humanity, to our fellow neighbors and friends, just like Ummu Ma'bad presented him to us. We have failed as a community in the United States to present our religion, present our prophet to people out there. And it hurts me so much, as another version, to see that philosophers, non-Muslims, like Gandhi, and thinkers like Bernard Shaw and Michael Hart and many others, their praises and recognition of Muhammad as a human being are surfing the internet and the communication methods, while we sit down and enjoy. And we are the ones that needs to be honored by presenting his personality to humanity. اللهم لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك ولك السلطان. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد ما رضي. ولك الحمد بعد الرضا ولك الحمد دائما أبدا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد. طب القلوب ودوائها ونور الأبصار وضيائها وعافية الأبدان وشفائها. آته يا ربنا الوسيلة والفضيلة والدرجة العالية الرفيعة والمقام المحمود الذي وعدته يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم أوردنا حوضه وأشربنا من يده الشريفة شربة هنيئة مريئة لا نظمأ بعدها أبدا. اللهم يا أكرم الأكرمين كما لم نره في الأولى لا تحرمنا رؤيته في الآخرة. اللهم احشرنا مع ملته واجعلنا من جماعته. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل شفاعته. حبب إلينا حبك وحب من يحبه وحب نبيك وحب الصالحين، واجعلنا يا ربنا وحببنا إلى خلقك، واجعلنا من أحبابك، من أوليائك، ممن لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون، من أهل البشرى في الدنيا والآخرة، من أهل الفوز العظيم، ممن تحبهم ويحبونك، ممن رضيت عنهم ورضوا عنك، ممن هديتهم وارتضيت الهدى لهم يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم ارحم أباءنا وأمهاتنا كما ربونا صغيرا. اللهم ارحم أباءنا وأمهاتنا كما ربونا صغارا. بارك لنا في أولادنا وذرياتنا وضرارينا أجمعين. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا اللهم راشدين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلي وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. أقم الصلاة.